This episode is brought to you by Dashlane. Never forget another password and keep all your credentials secure by signing up for a free account today. What's red, wet, and even apocalyptic for some? It's blood rain. While the rain is not actually blood, its strange appearance has instilled fear into many who have witnessed it. In ancient times, blood rain, which is also called red rain, was considered a bad omen. NASA Earth Observatory describes an early account of red rain by the Roman historian Livy back in 191 BC. It disturbed the Roman Senate so much that they decreed that the consuls should sacrifice full-grown victims to whatever gods it deemed proper. Another source states that in Germany, showers of blood rain warned villages of the outbreak of the Black Death in 1348 to 1349. Over the years, superstition has given way to more rational explanations of this striking phenomenon, which we will explore in this episode of the Infographics Show, What Caused the Blood Rain? One common source of blood rain is dust from the Sahara Desert combining with storm clouds. According to NASA Earth Observatory, colored rain or snow occurs when dust plumes and storm systems meet, though only when raindrops fall through a dust plume beneath the level of the clouds. How red the rain is depends on the amount of iron oxide the dust contains. Low amounts of iron oxide will make the rain seem more brown than red. And not all blood rain events stain everything they touch red. It depends on the concentration of dust to rainwater. Weather expert Phelan Eden states, heavier, more prolonged rainfall simply ends up washing away the residue. Where the blood rain from Saharan dust falls depends on wind and weather patterns. It often appears somewhere in Europe. The BBC reports that blood rains happen a few times a year in the UK, but is more common in southern Europe like Spain and the south of France, which are closer to the Sahara. A strange variation on blood rain caused by red dust occurred in Siberia earlier this year. On July 3, 2018, blood rain fell in the industrial town of Norilsk. A Life Science article reported that the plaguey rain stained cars red, spread blood-colored puddles over the asphalt, and cultivated the general vibe of a town into a horror movie. While the blood rain created excitement and alarm for some living in Norilsk, its cause turned out to be rather mundane. Instead of red dust from the Sahara Desert, the dust came from a local man-made source. Life Science reports that the wind blew away a large amount of uncovered iron oxide, or rust residue, from the local Nornickel metallurgical plant. The rust dust drifted over the plant's parking lot, and the wind combined it with rain that was falling at the time. These conditions created a miniature blood rainstorm that the locals will probably remember for years to come. Besides colored dust, there are also biological causes of blood rain. Two examples of biologically derived blood rain occurred in recent years. One article provides an overview of an incident that happened in 2001. It describes how the state of Kerala in India had a series of recurring blood rainstorms. For two full months through the end of summer, every time it rained, the land was drenched crimson. At first, scientists thought it might be dust from the Rub al-Khali Desert in Saudi Arabia, creating a scenario similar to the one caused by Saharan dust in Europe. This theory was rejected after two physicists named Godfrey Lewis and Santosh Kumar made the surprising discovery that the particles were actually living cells. What added to the mystery was that Lewis and Kumar could not find nuclei or other genetic material in the cells. There was another strange element: reports of a loud bang distinct from thunder occurring just hours before the first blood rain. Because of these factors, they proposed that the cells were extraterrestrial in nature. They theorized that the blood rain in Kerala was caused by panspermia, which the article describes as organic material moving from one world to another. More specifically, they believed the red alien cells were from a comet that entered Earth's atmosphere and exploded over Kerala. Most of the mass media loved the panspermia theory and ran stories about it without questioning it. However, there is a third and more plausible theory about the cause of Kerala's blood rain. Scientific examination of a red rainwater sample by Kerala's Center of Earth Science Studies revealed that the particles appeared to be spores. Government botanists reproduced the spores and discovered upon re-examination that they were those of an unremarkable and extremely common local algae called Trentophilia, which is heavy with red-orange carotenoid pigments. The specific type of Trentopolia is Trentopolia annulata. Trentopolia spores are described as stratospheric spores. This means that they are typically found in the atmosphere. Instead of dust, an unusually large bloom of spores mixed with storm clouds in the area, and blood rain was the result. The article pointed out that the main flaw in Lewis and Kumar's research technique is that they tried dyeing the spores without growing them. with the end result being that the cell membranes remained intact and they saw no genetic material. If they had cultured the cells the way the botanists did, they could have broken the cell walls, which would have made the cells easier to die and the genetic material easier to see. Lewis and Kumar probably did not think of doing this because they were physicists and were completely outside of their specialty. Unfortunately, despite this solid scientific evidence about Trentopolia spores, Lewis and Kumar's alien spores from outer space still remain a popular explanation for Kerala's 2001 blood raid incident even today. In 2014, a similar but less exciting blood rain incident happened in Zamora, Spain. When blood rain fell there, a resident took samples of the red rainwater and gave them to scientists at the University of Salamanca. University researchers examined the samples and found that, as in Kerala, the cause of the blood rain was algae. However, it was a different type of algae called Homotacus pluvialis. According to one source, this freshwater algae is green but turns red in times of chemical stress due to a carotene pigment called astaxanthin. However, one mystery that the researchers could not solve was where the Homotacus pluvialis spores came from. They are not local to the area and are not found in nearby water sources. While blood rain may be startling to see because it seems abnormal, it is really nothing to be afraid of. In the recent examples we have seen of red dust causing blood rain, the red dust has been sand particles from the desert and rust scrapings from a metallurgical plant. The levels of dust involved in these blood rain events were not dangerous to humans. In the cases of blood rain in Kerala and Zamora, neither type of algae is harmful to humans. In a discussion of Trentopolia spores in a 2015 news article, Dr. Felix Bast of the Central University of Punjab said that this microalgae is absolutely harmless. He also states that blood rainwater is perfectly potable even for vegetarians. As for the algae responsible for the blood rain in Spain, it is safe enough to eat. A Daily Mail article notes that Homotacus pluvialis is used in the pharmaceutical industry for its antioxidant properties and in food production to give salmon and trout a deeper red color. Blood rains prove that there's a lot of things to worry about in life already, and the last thing you want to be worrying about is your digital safety online. So try Dashlane completely free for 30 days and discover how much easier your password life can be. To make the lives of the staff at the Infographics Show easier, we've all started using Dashlane. Dashlane is a password manager that makes it easy for you to control your digital identity. Whether you're great with computers or not, Dashlane is extremely easy to use. Anytime you have to come up with a new password, you can use Dashlane to generate a super secure one. The security of Dashlane is awesome, but the autofill is what makes it so much fun to use. You'll never have to log into another website again because Dashlane does it for you automatically. Dashlane is available for PCs, Macs, iOS, and Android devices, and if you use Dashlane Premium, you can sync your passwords and secure login details across all your devices. Become more secure and support the Infographics Show at the same time by using the code INFOGRAPHICS, and get 10% off Dashlane Premium from the get-go by going to dashlane.com/infographicsshow or by clicking the link in the description. So, have you ever seen blood rain? Or have you seen some other unusual type of rain? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called Cannibal Island, The Real Battle Royale. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!